Hi there, I'm Tim Gardner, the founder and CEO of Riffyn. Riffyn provides groundbreaking cloud software called Riffyn Nexus for intelligent process development in biopharmaceuticals and biotech. In this five-part series of 2 to 3 minute videos, we will demonstrate the core capabilities of Nexus. Let me start with a high-level overview of what makes it unique and how it works. Riffyn Nexus offers a paradigm-changing approach to scientific experimentation and manufacturing process development. It's what we call a process data system. The architecture of Nexus is organized around visual blueprints of your laboratory and production processes. Illustrated here is the graphical design system used to define those processes. The blueprints form a digital twin which serves as a backbone to collect and integrate all of the process data for real-time machine learning. Let me outline for you how that works. You start by defining a process. Then data is acquired and mapped onto the design of the process, and then the Riffyn Nexus data integration engine automatically shapes that data for analytics and machine learning. The resulting insights drive rapid process improvements, which are captured in the next design cycle. Those drive more powerful experimental results and faster insights about your products and processes. This capability is really powerful once you incorporate it into your organization's workflows. For example, Riffyn's first major customer, Novazymes, brought 4 yeast biofuels products to market in 18 months. That's twice as fast as any product development program in their decades-long history. You can download the case study at riffyn.com. Since our start with Novazymes in 2017, we've taken a leading position in industrial biotech, biomaterials, and food. We also serve many customers in biopharmaceuticals, particularly in cell line development, upstream and downstream process development, formulations development, and the manufacturing sciences. In this 5-part series, we will illustrate the core capabilities of Riffyn Nexus: process design, experiment setup, data capture, design of experiments, and its data integration engine for powerful real-time analytics. So let's get started with a demonstration of process design. The Riffyn Nexus application is accessible through a web browser as shown here. Before I illustrate how to design new processes in Riffyn, I'd like to point out that many different types of processes can be defined in Riffyn. For example, you could define a fermentation process. You could define media preparation. You could define HPLC processes, COVID assays, tumor progression studies, and even chemical synthesis processes. The design of a new process starts with the definition of a step. For example, here you see the bioreactor step on a cell culture process. Once created, you then add inputs and outputs. Here we add a bioreactor. We can also add as an output the cell culture, which comes out of the bioreactor. These terms come from controlled vocabularies, which are built into Riffyn Nexus. Once you've added those terms, you can then create further steps such as taking samples and biomass analysis on those samples or HPLC analysis on those samples. After creating inputs and outputs on your steps, you can then augment them with properties which also come from controlled vocabularies. These include the definition of acceptable units. And you can add your target and upper lower spec limits. These specifications serve both as the basis for well-controlled processes and also the specifications for the products produced by the processes themselves. As you refine and iterate on your process, you may find that it's necessary to redefine the workflow sequence. You can do that using the step sequence feature. That's important because this workflow defines the order of procedural tasks, which you can find on the right. Here we're adding procedural items to take samples. You can augment these procedural items with video files and other information. If you're watching carefully, you'll notice that I put the wrong procedural items on this step, but you get the idea. Once you're happy with your design, you can save a version of that, both for future reference and for future execution of the experiments. Here I want to show you another really cool feature. You can actually take processes and break it into modular groups. Those groups form their own sub-processes, which can be recomposed into new processes. For example, we're going to take this HPLC step, convert it to a group, and then save it as its own process. Once you've done that, it becomes linked into this process, and you can drill down and augment that with its own steps. Or you can delete that sub-process and re-add it not only to this process as a module, but you can also add it to any other process as a reusable module. Once you've done that, you can of course save it as another version, and then you can perform experiments on that version or any of the prior versions. And that's what we'll show you in the next video in this series.